In an instrument, when you assign a sample to a modulation set and an effects chain, normally you're stuck with the choice you've made. However, by employing a bit of ingenuity, there's a couple of ways around this. When a sample plays in an effects chain, the send device can be used to route the audio to another effects chain chosen with the receiver. And what's easy to miss though is that the receiver can be changed, since it's actually a valid target as a destination for meta devices. So, you can use their power to create a custom method of switching effects chains. If you're unfamiliar with how the meta devices work, then check out the series of videos that cover their functionality. And by the way, this also works in the pattern editor to switch to a different send track. And the receiver can be changed directly via effect commands and graphical automation. For those who are familiar with using macros, you've probably already figured out that, yes, you can use them to switch an instrument's effects chain. None of this is possible with modulation sets, though. So we're going to have to get a bit sneakier with the available options. Enter the stepper. But this just moves to a new step when a note is played. Precisely. Use it in the volume domain with a length equal to the number of sets that you want to switch between. Give a step a value of 1 and make the rest 0. Then alternate this for each of the modulation sets. Duplicate your sample or samples and assign each of the copies to a different set. Now, whenever a note is played, it will appear as though the sound is switching between modulation sets. Additionally, those new samples can be assigned to different effects chains. And you might even consider combining this with the previous method of switching effects chains.